Hey everyone, welcome to my channel. So yesterday I decided to go out of town. There's a big music festival here in Skagen. Not music that I'm in any way interested in, and mostly it means lots and lots of people in the streets. Well, lots and lots of people who are loud and drunk and being, you know, adult Scandinavians having an opportunity to drink. So going to the train station, I just took my bike and decided to go first to Frederikshavn and then maybe go on a ride south of there. But when I arrived in Frederikshavn, it was pouring with rain. So I just decided to go and get a bite to eat and see if it would let up. On the way, I found a used shop. Just used things, not necessarily one thing or another, like the previous ones I've shown you, and I decided to go and have a look. And in the back they had some vinyl records, some CDs and stuff, and so briefly filmed that, and started just talking to the guy who ran the place, and we had a nice chat. And that's why I didn't film so much, because he was about to close up. Shops close mostly around 2 and 3 o'clock here in Denmark on Saturdays, unless they're part of a big chain or something. So I just thought I'd quickly show you some of the stuff that I actually ended up buying. Very cheap, by the way. So a lot of 1980s memory lane stuff here. King Wild, the second time. So this was from her. Was this from her fourth vinyl album or third? Which I have, by the way. There's the MCA label there. And another slightly older, Kim Wilde, Cambodia, which I think was from her second album, which was not as successful as her first. Her first, of course, was the one with Kids in America. And here's an RAK label. And I found this one, Twisted Sister. We're not gonna take it. Including previously unreleased live tracks. So this is a German. This is a German copy. Oh, nice Atlantic label. Another 80s hit here. Kajagoo, Too Shy, with Limahl. They folded quite quickly after this. They made a single for, or was that Limahl himself, The Never Ending Story? And then they made one other album as just Kaja, with Nick as the singer. And here's the 1980s British EMI label. It's funny when you buy a Nar Maiden single or a Kaja Guga single and they look exactly the same label wise back then. Another 80s gem, Human League, Louise, BW, VW, The World Tonight, and here we have the Virgin. What do you call this, a stamped label? Filled in label? Because this is like, this is paint. I thought back then it was mostly the French singles who had that label. Funboy 3. Our Lips Are Sealed. There's another Chrysalis filled in label there. And we have another 80s, British 80s hit, Bronski beet. Why? Beside his Cadillac car. Yet another one of these labels. This one I thought was fun to find. There's an old Bananarama. This is before Stock Aitken and Waterman got their hands on them. Na na hey hey, kiss him goodbye. And the B-side is Telltale Signs. Telltale Signs. From the forthcoming LP Deep Sea Skiving. And I love this label. This is really nice. And being a Norwegian Dano-Norwegian Scandinavian person, this is of course the biggest hit of any Norwegian group anywhere. Aha, Take On Me from 1985. Not the first version of it, but the one that made it around the world. Made it to number one on the US Billboard. Did you guys hear that? It's windy here today. And here's the Warner Brother label. And I also got a couple of vinyl records. Here's a band I do love them a lot. They're not very well known outside the UK, if even. They're basically a prog rock band that decided to start their career when punk started. It's City Boy. I got my first City Boy record probably 45 years ago when I was a member of a record club as a kid. And I got that fantastic The Day the Earth Caught Fire. Since then I bought one more used about 6 or 7 years ago, and then this one. So I'm not actually buying them in a quick succession, but yeah, I really like them. Those are the white, but it's printed inlay paper here. The record itself looks like it needs a good wash. It also has the lyrics here. And the band and this wonderful Mercury label, which meant that this is actually looks like it's an American copy, because City Boy was on Vertigo in Europe. Finally, and this is such a... I've wanted to get Kiss on vinyl for many years. I have Kiss on CD pretty much locked up and everything. I had lots of Kiss vinyl records when I was 6, 7, 8 years old. And then I lent them to the street bully. I thought he would give me, he would ease off and leave me be my friend. And I was friends with his younger brother, who was a really nice kid. Time passes and I keep asking him to get them back. And he either tells me to F off or he has some sort of excuse. And so finally, I get my older brother to go and talk to the guy's father. Why I didn't get my dad to do it, because I was embarrassed, maybe, I don't remember, but he did so, my brother, and my brother, I mean, I'm, 8 years old at this stage, and my brother is a, he's gonna be 24, and he tells this guy's father, you know, your kid borrowed 9 Kiss albums from my brother, I want them back. So the dad confronts him, and turns out that this schmuck, this verkackte scheister, has used all my Kiss albums as targets for his BB gun, or air gun, or whatever you call them, and also he's blown them up in part with firecrackers. And this dad obviously knows what kind of person his kid is, so he goes up to the his son's room and he grabs the best thing he can from there, and he goes to his own record collection and he picks out his own 14-year-old at this stage copy of the Rolling Stones number 2, which I still have, which means it's a, you know, an original Scandinavian pressing, I think. And he gives that to my brother, and he gives his kid's telescope to my brother. The kid protests, but according to my brother, he just gave his son a look, and we'll, you know, we'll talk more about this later. I wasn't there. I was hiding at home because I was embarrassed. So yeah, that's how I lost my Kiss collection and added something pretty cool to my Rolling Stones collection. I still have that. But when I saw this in the store, you saw yesterday, I didn't even check what coin quality it was. He wanted 100 Danish kroner for it. All in all, this would have cost me 360 or 80 kroner, and he knocked it down to 300, so that was really nice of it. But I always had this was my last Kiss album that I bought, and I had just gotten it when I unfortunately lent it and all the other Kiss albums away to that kid. And I always had a thing for Unmasked. It's not their best album in my opinion. My favorite Kiss album is Harder Than Hell and Love Gun. But as you can see, nothing special about the inner cover here. This is a Scandinavian company, a print. I don't know if the vinyl was made in Scandinavia, but they always come with some sort of indication that the cover has been printed somewhere in Scandinavia. Sometimes Sweden, sometimes Norway. But what I thought was kind of cool about this copy, I mean, it's from 1980, and it still has the poster. Check it out. The Unmasked poster. And there's not even any holes in it. It hasn't been used as a... No, it's hung it up on the wall. There's no sticker marks or anything. So yeah, of course, this album seems to be mostly written by other people. It says Paul Stanley and it says Gene Simmons, but it also says Vinnie Poncian almost everything. So the only two songs on this that isn't a collaboration are the two Ace Frehley songs. Because he was actually taking part of this. Peter Criss, of course, at this stage had left the band, but they still put him on the cover. And I think this was where he performed in a video. And that was it. Peter Criss was gone. But anyway, I thought this was cool. This ended up being longer than I was supposed to have, but hope you liked checking that out on my little trip yesterday. Thank you so much for watching. I appreciate it. Please click like and subscribe. And just have a great July. Thank you. Bye. Oh, and a quick white Australian flag. Unmasked was probably their biggest seller in Australia. They even toured Australia only, far as I remember, with the Unmasked album. They didn't tour it with in America, they toured some in Europe, but yeah, Shandy, big hit in Australia, so I thought I'd show my beautiful Australian flag. Bye.